recognized symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
Sir Edward Elgar.
And a whole host of security people. Tremendous golden opportunity for him as he gets a crack at Hulk Hogan and the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Look at Elizabeth, she's lovely, as always. Cunning but lovely.
Yes, but don't be fooled by that loveliness.
Well, you know what that sound means, Alfred.
It's the one and only. Just can't hear yourself speaking here, Gorilla, for the ovation that this crowd has given Hulk Hogan, World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion.
Macho Man just shoved Elizabeth out in front of him towards the Hulk. Look at Elizabeth, she's bewildered. She doesn't know what's going on. As the Macho Man keeping her between he and the Hulk, who looks in tremendous condition.
I've never seen the Hulk looking better.
This match is one fall with a 1 hour time limit for the World's Heavyweight Championship. First, the challenger. He is accompanied by Elizabeth from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 238 pounds, the Intercontinental Champion, Randy the Macho Man Savage. And the champion from Venice Beach, California, 302 pounds, Hulk Hogan.
Hogan threatening to clobber the challenger with the championship belt. Want to make it clear here, Alfred, that the Intercontinental title is not on the line, only the World's title.
Yes, that is a point that must be reckoned with, so
Hogan has everything to lose and nothing to gain here.
Exactly, that is the situation with him. But as far as Savage is concerned, it's more or less the same situation for him, because if he doesn't win the World Heavyweight Champion this time, will he ever get another chance?
Well, he can leave here and still be the Intercontinental Champion with a loss.
That's true. That is absolutely true.
But if the Hulkster was to lose, he leaves here with nothing.
And that, unfortunately, is very true also.
Elizabeth is still inside the ring, and a referee calls for the bell. I can't believe it. Oh! Macho Man makes a hasty retreat, but right back in. Oh, is he quick. Just like lightning.
You are not going to sneak up on the World Heavyweight Champion and catch him unawares right in the beginning of a match. That is for sure. Very unlikely. And not only that,
though, that the referee rang the bell with Elizabeth still inside the ring ropes.
Well, I think he saw what was happening there, and he rang that more or less as a warning to Hulk Hogan, be careful.
Savage now on the outside, about to come back in over the top. He'll have to rely on every bit of that quickness of his and that cunningness of his to survive this one.
That's true, but the Macho Man is quick and will remain quick all through this bout.
Oh, there's the awesome power of the Hulk. And he takes a hike. Trying to break the momentum of the champion who has everything going his way right now.
Hulk Hogan is absolutely fantastic.
Champ going out, Hogan. Talk about winning the respect in the hearts of wrestling fans all over the world. That man right there has done exactly that. And deservedly so.
Absolutely. Isn't he incredible? Everybody knows him. In every incredible corner of the world, if you go to the tiniest village in India, they know Hulk Hogan.
Savage out there at ringside looking for something or someone. Just about to be counted outside the ring. And now look, he's mimicking the champion. Side headlock now by the challenger. Hulk won't stay in this too long. He's got too much power. Got rid of in a hurry, drops down in front, over the top, Macho Man, beautiful shoulder block by the champion, and down goes Savage, and the Hulk right on his case.
He moves so smoothly for 300 pounds plus, and he just seems to glide, and yet he does it with speed.
Uh-oh. I believe he just spat at the champion, and then slithered out of there like a snake.
A little snaky sliver there got him out of trouble. If he's looking for inspiration from the crowd here, I don't think he's going to get it.
He's not going to get it. Hulk said, please don't count this guy out. Let him come back in. Macho Man had a steel chair or two in his hands. He thought better of that.
I think he had two steel chairs.
Yeah, they were hooked together. He said, look, here I am. What are you hollering about? I'm right here.
You know, I don't think a steel chair would help him against Hulk Hogan.
Beautiful shot right over the back of the shoulder of beautiful Elizabeth as these two guys, like two Bravo Bulls, getting ready for a conflict here. Oh, look at this. Turn around is fair play. Yeah. Savage beside himself, perched up on top, some 15 feet high in the air. And the Hulkster never took his eye off him, saying, come on, I'm waiting for you.
He'll knock him out if he jumps off there. He'll knock him clean out. And Savage knows that too. He's not going to do that. Back he goes.
So if you want to do it out here, let's go out and do it on the floor. Come on. Right out here on the concrete. Savage not about to do that, Alfred.
No, he knows that there is one place he wouldn't win.
Hulk will have to be careful getting back in here because the quickness of Savage is second to none.
That's true, and he's a master strategist in the ring as well, Savage. He can use those ropes and those corners better than any man I've ever seen. Look at him now.
Just like a gazelle right over that top rope. Oh, look at that. Champion stopping Danny Davis from counting again, saying, I don't want you to count this guy out.
No, he said, let me have a piece of him first. A big piece.
Savage out there obviously looking for something.
Well, this is one of Savage's game plans, one of his strategies that he has been successful with.
Now he wants to be friends.
Yeah.
Everything I said about you, disregarded.
Yes.
You're a nice guy.
Yeah. And did he say, please believe me?
Oh, look at that. Hulk not taking any chances. Takes the offense immediately. Wow, what a right hand. Hulkster now winding him up here. Look out below. Oh, what a clothesline. Savage won't be able to take too many more shots like that.
A short chopping blow to the forehead there. A power slam in the corner. Now what is the Hulk going to do?
Watch out. Oh, that's 300 pounds plus coming down on you.
Two. Three. Oh, look at that. I love it. I love it.
Hulk just oozing with confidence here. Atomic drop coming up. Oh, a beauty. And Savage right to the outside.
And he wonders what on earth is happening. Ow!
Champion right out there after him. Oh, look out, Elizabeth. He pushed her right in front of him. Give me a break.
Oh, look at that. Please don't hit me, Hulk.
Elizabeth being pulled right in front of the Macho Man. And the Hulkster just had to walk away.
Well, he's a gentleman. He's not going to do anything while a lady is there. And I hate to say, not necessarily a lady. Looks can be awfully deceptive.
Chant going out here from the Boston Garden, Hogan, and the Macho Man, or not so Macho Man, does not like it. Coming in very carefully, Elizabeth, obviously very concerned. I think she's concerned about being pulled in front of the Hulk again.
When Savage uses her as a shield, do you think she does that willingly, or do you think that Savage forces her to do that?
I don't believe she does that willingly, Alfred. Oh, it's the champion now who's outside, but did not go all the way to the floor as the Macho Man scoops him back inside. Oh, look at this.
Incredible power. Whoop.
Hulkster sending him in for the ride and follows him up with a clothesline.
Oh,
oh
my word.
Mackerel.
Yes, he said. Yes.
Hulk Hogan having a good time here in the Boston Garden. Suplex coming up.
Making an example of it.
Oh, beauty.
Twisted him in midair and brought him down right on his head. Take that.
Savage rolls out again, and the champ going around the other corner to beat him. It's a foot race now. Oh, look at that. Elizabeth's trying to scoot out of the way. Oh, he got caught coming in. That's what we spoke about earlier.
Yes, that's definitely a ploy by Savage. As we said before, he's been successful with that strategy.
Challenger now sticking the fingers right into the eyes of the champion. And now going to the outside, Macho Man on the top, bombs away, coming up. Double axe handle right to the back of the neck of the champion. Over for the cover, hooks the leg, no way.
Not even a one count. Even so, the Hulk seems to be dazed and stunned and hurt.
He certainly is, and now he's gone out. Right to the concrete, Macho going to the top again.
This is his move. This is the Macho Man's move.
Look out, he got him.
This could be all over for the Hulk. It could be the loss of the World Heavyweight Championship right here and now.
Champion in a whole lot of trouble down on the concrete here, now about to get rammed right into the barricade, and over it goes.
Smashing that barricade, all the security men around to keep it clear.
Macho Man having to bail into the ring to stop the count.
This could be the beginning of the end for Hulk Hogan. History could be made here. right in Boston Garden.
Obviously hurt. And Savage right on his case, unloading with everything he's got, realizing this is the golden opportunity for him. He wants him in the ring. A count out will not get him the title.
Then he's going to the top rope again. And the Hulk is down still.
Another double axe handle. Champion could be out of it. We could be seeing history made here in the Boston Garden. One, two, no.
Just raise that shoulder. He didn't push the challenger off. He just raised the shoulder. The Hulk is definitely hurt.
Champion now in for the ride. Oh, nice.
Oh, big clothesline
by the challenger. He won't get him now. That arm is out of there. Arm was out of there. No. Two count only.
My word, that was the closest I've ever seen to Hulk being defeated right there and then. That was almost a three count.
Said he stopped the count 2 inches from the mat.
Look at the world champion. He's down and he's struggling.
Macho now going once again.
Again.
For that patented flying elbow. Will he get it? Oh, my God.
The Hulk hasn't been able to move.
Oh, look at that.
Wow. Just look at the Hulk now.
Hulkster coming to life.
He's ducked down deep for this.
He's got that adrenaline flowing. It's going to take a whole lot to hurt him right now. Savage teeing off, but not having much effect.
Oh. Boom.
Roundhouse right by the champion and another one.
Flattened the Macho Man. Slammed him into the corner. Now what's he going to do?
Look out. Booth coming up. Challenger caught that one right between the eyes.
And fell flat on the concrete.
Elizabeth over there to try to help him out. Uh-oh.
Hulk's and Hulk is up.
Wait, she's saying, wait a minute.
Now there you are. You see, that's what I'm telling you. He's not forcing her to do that. She's doing it willingly. She's a co-conspirator.
She's saying, wait a minute. Oh, look at this. Elizabeth just being picked up by the champion and moved out of the way.
While he was a gentleman, he just picked her up nicely, you could say. Uh-oh, look at him. Savage going in.
Oh, Savage.
Oh, Hulk.
Playing a little possum there. Caught the champion with that boot.
Elizabeth bought him some time, enough for him to recover.
Look out. Oh, look out.
Look out, Hulk.
Andy Davis just got clotheslined. Accidentally by the champion, who's now knocked outside the ring.
The referee is right
down out here ringside.
He's snatching the belt.
For the belt.
What is he going to do now?
Flying.
He's going to jump from the top corner with that belt.
Look out. Oh.
Oh, right to the head of the Hulk.
Right between the eyes of the champion with that steel belt. And referee still out on his back inside the ring.
That's a solid gold belt, and that's very, very heavy.
This is the most trouble I've ever seen Hulk Hogan.
I've never seen Hulk suffer like this before. He's laying down there with the belt on his chest, but does he know what's happened?
Savage now telling the referee to count this guy out.
Which he's doing.
He's about to do it.
And it looks as if the Hulk is cut.
Hulk is busted wide open after being clobbered with his own belt.
And I believe the referee has given this to the Macho Man.
Well, he won't win the title that way, Alfred. Can't win it on a count out of disqualification, only on a pinfall or submission.
But it's going to go into the record book that he's beaten the world champion.
Absolutely.
When clearly to you and I, he hasn't.
Well, the Hulk was counted outside the ring. I think he would have been disqualified by the referee anyway. He just clobbered the referee with a clothesline. Let's get the official word.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match, by a countout, Randy the Macho Man Savage.
That is an absolute travesty of justice, if ever I have seen one.
Macho Man victorious here in this match. Champion still on his back. bleeding profusely. You can see the blood everywhere.
So therefore, the world champion remains Hulk Hogan.
Doesn't want to turn loose at all. Oh, look at that. Just nailed Danny Davis with a right hand.
He knows that's not his.
Savage holding on to that championship belt, but it doesn't belong to him. It belongs to that man right there, Hulk Hogan.
Well, Hulk Hogan is still the world champion, but does this make Randy Savage the number one heavyweight in the world? What is the situation now?
Absolutely not. Look at the Hulkster just coming to life, realizing what's transpired here right out after the Macho Man. He wants another piece of him.
He's got the Macho Man up on the show, bringing him back.
Hulkster carrying the Macho Man back to the ringside. Blood pouring out of his forehead.
Whoa. Hulkster is going to show you exactly what he should have done before.
Talk about your true champions. You're looking at one right here in Hulk Hogan.
A taste of his own medicine.
He's going to clobber him with the belt up there. Look out. Oh, he ducked underneath it.
And is he running? Look at the Macho Man. He's quick.
Savage headed for higher ground as that man right there, the world's champion, erupted. Wow, what a match.
The most incredible match of 1986. Look at that man.
Hulk Hogan pushed to the limit by the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion Macho Man Randy Savage. I don't know, if Savage could have got him back inside the ring, we might have had a new champion.
I don't know about that, Gorilla, but I'm going to say this. There is a defeat for the World Heavyweight Champion, and how rare is that?
Hulkster not too happy.
It goes down in the record book, Hulkster. You lost one.
Certainly did. Victorious here in the Boston Garden, Macho Man Randy Savage with a victory over the Hulkster. Well, our ring announcer explaining once again to the fans that the only way the title can change hands is on a pinfall or submission. The count out disqualification certainly will make you lose the match, but not the championship. Talk about charisma. Even in defeat, the Hulk has charisma.
Isn't he magnificent? Look at him. The greatest professional athlete in the whole of the world. Devoted to his fans and dedicated to his chosen career.
Standing ovation for Hulk Hogan, even in defeat here in the Boston Garden, a happening for sure. Saying he's thanking the man upstairs. Let's go back and take a look. And after the match was over, he went back. There goes the Macho Man with the ligament on his shoulders with the belt. And the Hulkster right on his case. Here he comes.
Look at Hulkster. He doesn't like that at all.
He just pushed about five security guards out of the way.
As if they didn't exist.
It's Hulk Hogan carrying the Macho Man.
Yeah.
Who's just carrying Elizabeth.
That's more like the caveman now. Down. In he goes, one for good measure, to hold him there. Scooped him up from under the bottom rope.
Gonna do a number now on the Macho Man. He wants a payback time. He wants to clobber him with a belt, just like Macho Man clobbered him and busted him wide open. But wisely, he scoots out underneath it and gone to higher ground. Unbelievable happening here in the Boston Garden. Still the world's champion, that man. But the winner of this match, Macho Man Randy Savage. We'll be back.